Good morning and welcome to Founders Metropolitan Community Church. We look forward to worshiping with you just momentarily. While we wait for service to begin, it's a good time for you, if you're on social media, to invite others to join us on Facebook Live. Start a watch party. Get all your friends involved. It's also a great time to go ahead and get your bread and cup ready for communion, whether it's your first time with us or multiple times with us. Now, get ready for worship. Would you join us this morning in our call to worship? Family, I have a word for you. Fulfillment. For God always fulfills God's word and promises.
We know that God wants to bring us closer to God's loving presence. Guide us, O God.
I have another word for you. Purpose. Do not be troubled. Rather, know that you are being guided for a greater purpose.
We know it can be difficult, yet we choose to trust and give thanks to God, whatever the situation.
In difficult times, when your hearts are troubled, just remember Christ Jesus left you an incredible gift.
We have a reason.
Amen. Join us in our opening song. Would you pray with me? Precious God, thank you for this time we have together. Thank you for the blessing of community. Thank you for the blessing of being able to worship together. Thank you for the blessing of life today. Thank you for everyone who is watching and listening at this very moment. We ask for you to reach out to wherever people are, not just physically where we are, but where are we in our lives, God? Meet the needs today. Help us to look to you as the resource of all resources, the one who promised to be with us, the one who promised to help us in our times of need. Bless everyone that is needing something today, and bless the rest of us who may not know we need something, but we sure are glad to be here and in your presence. If there's one person watching in this very moment that doesn't know you personally, I ask that they know you personally today, that they know who the great I am is. And we'll give you praise and glory, for it's in your name we ask it. Amen. Amen. We are so delighted to see you today. If this is your first time with us, then let me introduce myself. I'm Reverend Keith Mazingo. I'm the senior pastor here at Founders Metropolitan Community Church in Los Angeles, the greatest church in the world. And we are so glad to see you here joining us today. If you haven't been before, well, welcome. We are so delighted to see you. Hope that you enjoy this service so much that you'll be back every Sunday. Of course, we want to say welcome to all of you who are joining us online, which is most of us. Most people are joining online, and we just want to say welcome. We're glad that you are here, too. It's always wonderful to know that you are here. We also want to say welcome to the in-house crew that is making service happen today. Last week, I was speaking to someone, and they said, I really want to be back to church, but I am so glad that I can at least be with my church family online every week. We all know what that feels like, so I just want to say thank you to those who are working behind the scenes, as well as the few that you see up on the stage today, making service happen. And now, we want to give you an opportunity to welcome one another. This is our time of passing of the peace, and the way we do that these days is this. If you're joining us on our website, through our website, please register your attendance. If you're joining us on social media, well, type in hello, hi saints, welcome family. Let us know that you are present. That works for two things. One, it gets you talking to one another. And when, you know, those of us that grew up in church, mama didn't let us talk in church, but we're letting you talk in church to one another. We want you to welcome one another and give peace to each other. It's also a way that we keep up with your attendance. So if you would, check in on social media so that we know that you're here. Amen. Well, this morning, before the reader comes to read our scripture, I have the opportunity to share something wonderful with you. We have had, over the last few months, four people to transfer their membership in to Founders Metropolitan Community. In the pandemic, people are joining our church. And also yesterday, Reverend Steve Swofford conducted a membership class. And we had someone in that class from Melbourne, Australia, and he'll be joining the church today. I have him here on phone, and so he can. I don't know if he speaks loudly. You might be able to hear him through my microphone. So we'll see. But he's watching. I think it's like 4 o'clock in the morning there or something. But 5 o'clock in the morning, so he got up at 5 this morning before, and this is Monday morning for him, so he got up at 5 o'clock this morning so he could be in worship with us before he skedaddles off to work, which is in the next room in his house, by the way, at the moment, because they're in pandemic mode too. But I want to share with you, we have several people who are transferring membership in, and this has been done, like I said, in the last few months, and even actually, the first one, if we'll bring up his picture, Reverend Wayne Lindsay, who was my second pastor in MCC and whom I got to work with for many years at St. John's MCC in Raleigh. Reverend Wayne Lindsay lives in Las Vegas, but he has transferred his membership to our church, and we are so delighted to have him. And he is also one of our volunteer staff pastors. So you have another resource if you need someone. Reverend Wayne Lindsay is here for you. Let's give him a hand.
All right, we love you, Reverend.
Yay, we love you, Wayne. He joins us on social media each Sunday and usually has a watch party going. We also have George Padilla. Most of you that have been around for a while, you know George and the blessing that he is. He had been a member of our church in the past and moved away. He lives in Palm Springs these days, but you know, he said, my heart is still at Founders, and he transferred just a few months ago his membership back. So we welcome you, George.
Yay,
today.
George. Woo! Yay, we love you.
Now these two, notice where they are.
Well,
I think that might be their wedding picture.
Nice.
I think they were wedded right here. This is Dennis Bell and Harold Huckins, who were members of our church in, I said it was Tucson. Was it Albuquerque? Okay, in Arizona.
Tucson.
I think it was Tucson, yes, Tucson. In Tucson, Arizona, and they are longtime members of Metropolitan Community Church, and they, in fact, Bill was a song leader, and Harold, an organist. So they're working on, I asked them yesterday if they could, or day before yesterday, if they could work on a piece to share with us in church sometime, and they said they'd get right on it.
All right.
They have moved their membership here to Founders Metropolitan Community Church, and they join us every week in worship. We are so delighted to see you, Bill and Harold.
Yay.
Give them a hand. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Right.
So we had four people that have transferred their membership, and we wanted to publicly acknowledge that. And now you see this beautiful person up on the screen. This is my, between him and Wayne Lindsay, they're my best friends in the whole wide world, and I have him here. He's smiling, even bigger than he is in the picture there. This is Derek Singletary, who lives in Melbourne, Australia, but he's a good North Carolina boy, just like me. We have been friends since our days back at St. John's MCC in Raleigh. So we've been friends about 30 years. And he had been a member in Melbourne for some years, and he has now decided he wants his membership here. And so he attended a membership class yesterday, and we just want to ask you, Derek, while you're here, so I can make sure that you get to say, I never knew I would get this opportunity. I'm so excited to be able to take it, because I think we joined the church at the same time at St. John's back in 1989. Oh, my goodness. A little few years there. And he's not as old as I am, though. He always wants people to know he's much younger than I am. And I just always remind him it's not that much younger. So, Derek, I'm going to ask you a few questions that we ask for members of Founders Metropolitan Community Church. And I love doing this publicly and not privately. And the reason I like doing it publicly is because it lets those people who are members be reminded of the commitments that we took for this church. It also lets new people know what we expect of members. So I ask you, and the answers will be, I will, hopefully. The first commitment I ask of you is, will you pray for this church, its leadership, ministries, and programming? He says, I will. All right. Will you support this church with your regular attendance, whether virtually or in person? I will, he says. And by the way, I know that he does that because he calls me during the week and tells me what I preached about the last Sunday. Will you live out your life with the core values of our denomination? That is, with a personal relationship with God, living in community, even if it's a virtual community, fighting for social justice and the oppressed, and living a life of inclusivity. He says, I will. If conflict arises, will you work through direct dealing just as Jesus taught in Matthew chapter 18? Boy, he was already shaking his head on that one. Yes, he says, I will. And will you support Founders Metropolitan Community Church with your faithful stewardship of time, talents, and finances? Yes, he does. So would you, before we give him a clap of applause, let's say a word of prayer over our new member and our transferred members. And yes, you'll see Derek's in the membership class yesterday with Reverend Steve Swofford. Wayne Lindsay's in that class as well. He decided he would come and revisit the class, and Reverend Alejandro and myself joined in just to say welcome to the new folks. Would you let's pray over these, our family. God, thank you for bringing new people into this congregation. Thank you for the history that they have with Metropolitan Community Church. Thank you for their relationship with you most of all. Thank you because as we know them and the ones we know well and then the ones that we learn even better over the next years, I pray, God, that you will be with them. Continue to move through them and let your spirit use them wherever they are. Because these are your people and there's no distance in your ministry through us. We are your hands. We are your feet. We are your heart, God. Going out to the world to represent and be the Jesus this world really needs to see. So I ask you to use each one of these in the many ways that you want to use us. And thank you, God. Some of these have been members since almost the beginning of the denomination. Harold and Dennis have been members, I believe, since 1975, and I don't think it was much later than that that Wayne Lindsay became a member. Of course, Derek and I came in 1989. God, I just ask you, lay your hand and your anointing on each one of us. And let us live out the rest of our lives in the plan that you have for us. And let this church be a blessing to each one of them as well. Because it's not just a one-way street. It's not just giving. It's also receiving. So let us be a blessing each to the other. And we'll praise you for it's in your name we ask it. Amen. Amen. Now will you give them all a wonderful applause? Yay. Amen. It's good to see you, my brother.
We love you, Derek.
We love you. We love you all. I know the others are watching online. We just want to say welcome to Founders Metropolitan Community Church.
Amen. Amen. How timely. This morning, as we share our sacred readings, the first reading is taken from Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 and 7, the Amplified Version. Do not be anxious or worried about anything.
Do you want me to leave my phone on, or you just want to watch through Facebook?
But in everything, every circumstance and situation,
leave the
by
phone
prayer
on or watch through.
And petition with thanksgiving, continue to make your specific request known to God. And the peace of God, the peace which reassures the heart, that peace which transcends all understanding, that peace which stands guard over your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus is yours.
All right.
Our second reading is taken from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verses 1 through 7 and 25 through 29, the Voice version. Jesus, don't get lost in despair. Believe in God and keep on believing in me. My Maker's home is designed to accommodate all of you. If there were not room for everyone, I would have told you that. I am going to make arrangements for your arrival. I will be there to greet you personally and welcome you home, where we will be together. You know where I am going and how to get there. Thomas, Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the path? Jesus, I am the path, the truth, and the energy of life. No one comes to the Creator except through me. If you know me, you know the Creator. Rest assured now, you know God and have seen God. I have spoken these words while I am here with you. The Creator is sending a great Comforter, the Holy Spirit, in my name to teach you everything and to remind you of all I have said to you. My peace is the legacy I leave to you. I don't give gifts like those of this world. Do not let your heart be troubled or fearful. You were listening when I said, I will go away, but I will also return to be with you. If you love me, celebrate the fact that I am going to be with the Creator, because God is far greater than I am. I have told you all these things in advance so that your faith will grow as these things come to pass. Hear what the Spirit says today. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Down and oh, my soul so weary. When troubles come and my heart burden be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sing. Up so I can stand on mountains.
to more than I can be. You raise me up to more than I can be.
And I don't know about you, but I've had a troubled heart all week. Got a call Monday morning that Keith Minan had passed away. He is a longtime member of this church, and he was a close friend of mine. So I don't know about you, but it's been an emotional roller coaster all week. Can have those moments where I'm just a puddle, I'm just a mess of sadness. And then we have these moments of joy with new members and wonderful friends joining us here that I've known for so many years. And it seems like God is gathering us back together here in our older years. And that's so wonderful. So let me ask you, have you had a troubled week? I have a feeling that many of us have been on an emotional roller coaster. Some of us for days, some of us for weeks, and some of us for months. Some of us for a lifetime, I suspect. Lord knows there's the pandemic anxiety that we all are feeling. There's anger that we can't do anything that we want to do. We're tired of it all. How many times have people said this week to me, I'm just tired of this. I want it to be over, and yet we have a surge going on in all 50 states, and there are some places in the world that have another lockdown because it has gotten so far out of hand. At one of my faith leaders' meetings this week, one of the ministers was talking about how she's got a few friends that she's going to gather with on Thanksgiving. And she said it would have ordinarily been several other friends, but it's only the friends that she knows are wearing their mask when they go out, are constantly washing their hands, are constantly staying in the house, and they don't go anywhere unless they absolutely have to. And she said, as much as I hated to say no to some other people that I would have ordinarily been with, there are some who just take it way too lightly. They don't wear masks. They go where they want to. And they just pretend it's not happening around them. And she said, I can't invite them, so I can't spend time with them. This pandemic, there's no end in sight. We've had people all over the world that have lost their jobs, people in our own church, in our faith community here at Founders. Two of our own board members, in fact, have lost their jobs during this pandemic. People are having to navigate through the system to find other means of support, and it's difficult. It's not necessarily impossible, it's just difficult. And it troubles your heart when you get that pink slip and say, we're not going to be able to pay you. I will say that two of our members have started their own businesses during a pandemic, so there is a silver lining. There is something that can be done, and they're able to make it because of what they're willing to do. Anybody besides me have election weariness here in the United States? People are, even friends from around the world are staying in touch, and they're just kind of shaking their head at the United States, like, you need to get it together. There are many voters that are excited and jubilant about the election results, at least what we think are the election results. As of last Saturday, I posted because I was in the bed snoozing. I had been up already, but I had fallen back asleep for a few minutes. And all of a sudden, I hear yelling and screaming So I got up and turned on my phone and walked out on the patio, and you could hear hooping and hollering and carrying on after the election results last Saturday. But I also know that I have family and friends that are just as upset as the other family and friends that are jubilant. It's emotionally draining. And while many believed that the election is over, the truth is it's not fully settled. And we continuously get reminded of that. Talked with another member that had a bad doctor's report this past week. Went and asked some questions of the doctor, and the doctor answered in the negative on all of the questions. Are you troubled yet? Is your heart troubled? And then when I got that call Monday morning that we had lost Keith, someone that loved his God and loved his church and loved his pastors, I'm going to tell you that. You know, every week or so, I would cook a big meal. During this pandemic, I've been cooking a lot more, but, you know, just cooking for one is not all that great. I end up cooking one big meal and then eating the same meal every day for a week. So I started calling him and saying, have you eaten dinner yet? And he would say, well, no. And I'd say, well, will you eat homemade cooking if it's from North Carolina style, Southern, you know, It's not gonna help your belt line. It's not gonna help your waistline at all. I'm gonna go on and tell you. He'd say, yeah, I'll eat that, bring it. So I'd stop by and hand him out. He'd come out with his mask on, and I'd hand the bag of groceries out, not groceries, but dinner out the window, and he would take the bag. And each week he would give me back the bag that from the last week with clean dishes in it. And always there was a little surprise in the bottom. So always, and I was like, wonder what's going to be in my bag today. And week before last, it was Little Debbie birthday cakes. Woo, they were so good, I never had those before. One week it was brownies. He liked Little Debbie, by the way. He probably had stock in Little Debbie Company or something. Nothing big, just something in the bottom of the bag to make me look forward to it. And I would say, why do you keep putting stuff in the bottom of this bag? You don't need to give me anything. And he'd say, but I feel bad because you're doing all the work. You're doing the cooking and the shopping and the bringing over. And I can't do anything. I said, last week when I dropped off the food, I said, how are you feeling? And he said what he always says to me. He said, I feel great. I feel really good. I'm feeling really good. He said, although I've got some pounds right here, but I can't walk like I did before the pandemic. I'm having to stay in. I can't go out for my walks like I want to. And he said, I'm just ready to get, he said, I'm just bored out of my skull. I just want to get back to worship. I just really want to go back to worship. And I said, well, I understand, we want you back at worship. He said, but I know I can't. I know I we're not there yet. He said, I'm just so thankful, and this new equipment seems to be working out really well. I can see it better on my little TV screen. And he said, and by the way, Keith, I don't think Keith ever missed one of my evening vespers during the week. He never signed in, and he probably never signed in on our social media when he went. Now he'll sign in, register if he goes through online. But he was on Facebook, but he never had one post and he never had one picture. He was just there to learn from all the rest of us, he said. Well, I'm going to tell you, I was so upset, and my heart was troubled. And then I looked this week with all of that on my mind at what I had put in place 2 months ago to preach today, a sermon about Thanksgiving and defeating a troubled heart. And I reread the scripture and I was like, Jesus says, don't let your heart be troubled. What? You know, I've said this before and I'll say it again. I think that was the stupidest thing Jesus ever told us? I do. Are you calling Jesus stupid? No, I'm not calling Jesus stupid. I'm just saying Jesus was telling his disciples, I'm getting ready to die. I'm going to be leaving you soon. And I need for you to pay attention to what I'm about to tell you. Don't let this bother you. Don't let this upset you. Don't let your heart be troubled. You believe in God, you believe in me. And I'm going away, but I'm going to come back and be with you, and I'm going to send you another comforter. Just don't let your heart be troubled. Things were about to change drastically in the disciples' lives. They were about to not have Jesus with them. Here's the thing. We can be upset and we can have a troubled heart because we're human. And I have a feeling that when Jesus did pass away, that those same disciples were really troubled and really upset. I have a feeling that his family was crying and weeping and wailing. I have a feeling that they went through all the stages of grief just like we do because they were human. And the ones that loved Jesus were really upset. Their hearts were troubled. So even though Jesus said, don't let your heart be troubled, he also knew that we were human and that we're going to experience loss in one way or another. Our systems will let us down. People will let us down. Our jobs will let us down. The economy will let us down. Our government will let us down. Political and religious leaders can let us down. Our family can let us down. And yes, even our own bodies can let us down. But there's one thing that we can count on. Jesus says, don't let your heart be troubled, because I will be with you. And I will send the Comforter to be with you. I'm going to send someone in my stead. My Spirit will come back to you as a Comforter, as a teacher, as a counselor. Oh yeah, I'm going to tell you, over the last few months, I've ripped and reared at the TV and the internet and the social media about all sorts of things. I have been upset about people's health issues and about my friend's death. And yet, at the end of every day, I can still find something to be thankful for. I'm thankful. I'm not thankful that Keith Minan passed away, but I'm thankful for the years that he was in my life. I'm thankful for the blessings he gave me. I'm thankful that he wanted to be a part of this church. And he wanted, did you know this church has moved 3 times since Keith has been a member? And do you know what he did? He moved from where he lived each time the church moved. You know why? Because he volunteers at the church and he wanted to be able to walk to church and he wanted to be able to walk during the week. He's the one that made our deposits every week. He was a banker in real life back before he retired. And he made our deposits and did some work for the treasurer every single week for years and years. He's been doing this. When we were in West Hollywood, he lived 2 blocks away. He could walk to the church. When we were on Franklin, he moved over into that area, bought a house over there and lived over there. Then when he moved here, well, he moved a little bit right down the street here. He wanted to be close to his church, where he found comfort, where he sensed God's presence in his life. That's something to be thankful for. That's something that most of us are not going to be willing to do. I can't move like that. What a blessing. I don't know how all the election stuff's going to turn out, but you know what? I'm thankful that we've got this far. I'm thankful that we've made it this far. I'm thankful when I look at the bottom line, that the Comforter has been with me through my tears, my anger, my sorrow, the burdens that I've carried. God's presence with me. You know, I played last week that song, Something Beautiful. All I had to offer you was brokenness and strife. That's a prayer. God, all I have to offer you is my brokenness and my strife. But you made something beautiful anyway out of my life. You made something. God, you did it. Did you know that God will accept our offerings of brokenness and strife just as much as joy and praise? God will take whatever offering we give. And here's the thing. I didn't learn this overnight. It wasn't just about reading it in the scriptures. It wasn't just because one preacher said it. It was a matter of learning and growing in my relationship with God that no matter how dark the day got, no matter how bad things were, God was with me. The comforter was right there. The teacher was right there. The counselor was right there. The shoulder I needed to cry on was right there. That didn't come easily. That came with a lot of hard knocks in life. But that is spiritual maturity. When we can still look past all of the death and the dying and the doctor's bad reports and the election trauma and the pandemic trauma and whatever's going on in our families and other places, our jobs, we can look past that and still find God deep within us, that Spirit of God that is a constant that we can depend on. No matter how much we wallow in our problems and our circumstances, Jesus' promises are yea and amen. Jesus said, I'm going to be with you. I'm going to be there. I may not physically be in your presence, but I will be there. You can count on that. You count on my Spirit to be right there with you no matter what life brings. And then the Apostle Paul comes along behind Jesus and says this, don't be anxious or worried about anything. But in everything, in every circumstance, in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving. We forget that part sometimes. We get the prayer and the petition part. The petition, Lord, let me ask you for what I need. Let me ask you for what I need. Let me tell you what I want. Let me tell you what I want. Santa Claus, Jesus, you know, bring me the gifts. Bring me the gifts. But it says with thanksgiving. And then continue to make your specific requests known to God. And the peace of God. Hallelujah. The peace of God, hallelujah, one more time, that peace of God, that peace that reassures the heart, that peace that transcends all understanding, that peace which stands guard over your hearts, stands guard over my troubled heart, stands guard over your troubled heart, that one, and the one that stands guard over your mind, when you think you're losing your mind, or maybe when you have lost your mind, that the Holy Spirit is there guarding your mind and guarding your heart in Christ Jesus. He says, it's yours. Not it might be yours, not it could be yours, not stand in line and you may get some if there's any left over, but that peace of God. That peace, that peace of God will be with you and in you, and it will guard your heart. Oh, my goodness, I may have a spell. Oh, hallelujah. I feel the presence of God in this place today. I want you to know we can find fingers to point. We can be angry and disappointed and hurt all we want to. But I have found that the longer I court that problem and fellowship with the problem and repeat the problem and renounce it, oh, to hold on to it, I've got to hold on to my pain. I've got to hold on to my hurt. The longer I do that, the more of the peace of God I'm ignoring. And it's right there for the taking. It's right there. For those of us who know God and are in that relationship with God, it's already inside of us. It's already inside of you. Let God do what God can do in spite of all of the mess around us. In spite of a pandemic, in spite of death, in spite of illness. I told you about the member that told me that she got a horrible report from the doctor the other day while we're on the phone. She was on speakerphone. And while we were on the phone, I could hear her in the background as I was speaking. And I said, well, okay, so the doctor said, let me go over this again. Let me make sure I understand what you're saying, because she wasn't all tore up and upset. And I was just thinking, if I had gone to the doctor and they told me what they just told you, I'd be upset. I'm not sure I'd even be able to talk to anybody for a while. But I said, now let me recount this. The doctor said this, and she said yes. And I said, and the doctor said this, and she said yes. And I said, and the doctor said this, and she said yes. I said, well, what are they going to do to treat? Nothing. I said, nothing. I said, well, what kind of pain? You must be walking in pain. What are you in pain? Are you bedridden? What? She said, no, I don't feel any pain. I feel just fine, thank you. I said, then obviously, and it was the spirit. I felt the spirit between the two of us. I almost dropped the phone. I said, you are just a walking miracle then. I think what you just told me from the doctor is you're a walking miracle. And she was hooping and hollering in the spirit on the other end. She said, I'm a walking miracle. I said, well, just keep walking, sister. Just keep walking. Stay with me as long as you can. Stay with us on this earth as long as you can. And I pray that it just continues to be without the pain. Oh, my goodness. When I was just thinking, if I was that person, I would have just been a mess. She wasn't a mess at all. She is a long-time server of God. She is a long-time relationship person with God. She knows what God is capable of, and she understood this scripture, both of these scriptures, that she didn't have to walk around with her heart troubled. She could walk around in victory and a miracle. She could walk around without pain when the doctors are like, I don't know, this doesn't make any sense. I said, you know what things the doctors don't know. You know something because you are in relationship with God, and God is seeing you through this. Oh, what a wonderful thing. I'm just telling you, we can stick with all the problems. You know, I can stay in my huddled ball crying and carrying on all I want to, and I may have to do that for a few minutes because I'm human. I may have to do that for a few minutes. I may have to think on it and rehearse it over and over and over and keep saying it out loud as if it's going to change. Saying it out loud won't make it change, no matter how many times I rehearse it. When it's all said and done, I have to look deeper than the pain and the hurt and the grief and the misunderstanding and the disappointment. I have to look past all of that in my heart and in my mind and find that that same spirit that's guarding my heart and my mind is living in me. So here's what I'm offering you today. Something the Apostle Paul offered a long time ago, and something that Jesus offered even before him. The cure for defeating a troubled heart. Amen.
Bob Staten. I'm the board of director representative on duty today, and officially from the board of directors, I want to just express our sympathy for the loss of Keith Mannin. Keith was a longtime member of FMCC, MCCLA. He served the church in many capacities, including a board member, office volunteered, and you know, he handled the tithe. He was dedicated to God and his church and his friends. While he, you know, while he had little to say, he was always excited about worship. His last conversation with Pastor Keith was how much he missed being in church and with his church family. Per his request, there will not be a formal service at this time. We will schedule something informally in the next few weeks. My biggest regret is I didn't get to know Keith better. He always greeted me with a smile and a handshake, and shame on me for not getting to know him better. So my ask to you, if there's someone out here in our church family you want to get to know better, do it now. Don't do like I did. Today, very important. The congregational meeting is this Sunday, 11:45. We'll hold our virtual congregational meeting today, November 15th, after worship at 11:45 a.m. If you do not, it'll be on Zoom. If you do not have a Zoom account, please download it. It's free. If you already have a Zoom account, please update it before Sunday. We will elect two board members and two lay delegates, vote on a bylaw change, receive reports from team leaders. The application reports are already available on our website. You can join the meeting by clicking on the link. It's very important, particularly for you official members, because we need to make quorum and so we can vote and conduct the church business. So very, very important that you hang on with us. Thanksgiving. Coming up quick, Thanksgiving volunteer opportunity. Founders MCC volunteers are needed to deliver Thanksgiving meals to seniors at the Los Angeles LGPD Center. They need people to work in pairs, you know, one to drive, one to run up and deliver. The registration link is in the church bulletin and the church e-news. So please, it'll be a lot of fun. Again, just reminding them of all the connection opportunities we have. Tuesday evening, Vespers at 6 p.m. on Facebook Live. Wednesday, Bible study at 7:30 p.m. English with Pastor Lucia, Spanish with Reverend Alejandro. Thursday, Pastor Pop-Up, 6 p.m. on Zoom. And Friday, my favorite again, Friday evenings, the Friday Vespers at 6 p.m. on Facebook. And don't forget, we always have our time of hospitality after worship on Sunday at the link. But again, congregational meeting, super important. And hope to see you all there.
As we prepare, let me just prepare for communion. Please take this moment to gather some bread and juice or other elements so you can celebrate communion with us. But I also just want to pause because there's just a reality that in a twinkling of an eye, life can just change. And we're so aware of that presence and that spirit. So I just want to pause for a moment and just invite all of us, virtually and physically present, just to take a deep breath. And release. And to always know that wherever you are, in cyberspace or in physical space, the presence of God and the spirit of MCC and all that we are is always with us, so that we don't have to be alone. The choice is ours. And so I have the privilege to share with you the prayers of the people that was written by Reverend Alex Escato for this particular day. Go with me in prayer. It is always a joy to be present with all of you as I humbly offer up the prayers of the people. And before I do, I would like to remind you that the white pillar candle is lit for all those who have become ill or have passed away as a result of the coronavirus. It's a reminder of the hope we have that one day all of this will be behind us. And so as we keep this in mind, please pray with me. Loving God, we have often heard that you will never give us more than we can handle. And yet this week, our beloved brother and friend has been called to return home. In the midst of so much that is happening, today we commit in choosing to trust you. Let me repeat that in my prayer. In the midst of so much that is happening, today we commit in choosing to trust you. We trust that you will give us enough peace of mind to calm our hearts. We trust that you will strengthen our faith with every challenge, every obstacle, every loss, and with every gain. Teach us in these critical times when we are unable to understand the why. Help us to better know the how. How to continue following Christ's path so that we may live out his truth. And in so doing, receive and share the energy of life given to us. And we know very well, when we pray in the name of Jesus, our Savior, that which we ask for will be heard. And so we pray for the repose of the soul of our beloved Keith Minen, as well as those saints, known and unknown, who have passed from mortal life to life eternal. We also continue to pray for an end to the pandemic, for those who are ill, for those who have experienced loss during these challenging times, for those who are struggling economically, emotionally, and spiritually. God of our hope, our lives are truly peace blessed because you continue to inspire us as we journey through these times. With grateful hearts, we pray in the name of Jesus, our Redeemer. Amen. So I extend an invitation to you. Friends at Founders MCC and MCCs around the world, we serve an open communion. That means you don't have to be a member of this church or any church to come to the table of God. And I think that's good news. And so as we prepare our hearts to celebrate communion, many of us know what it feels like to be turned away from the table. And then there's that one defining moment when you are welcomed. Welcome because you are an integral part of God's family. Your presence brings strength when we are in communion through community. Whether you are at home or elsewhere, connected through a social network, or here at the church, in coming together, we are celebrating God's grace and mercy that brings us together through one spirit as God's family. And through this common table, we are transformed into Christ's self-giving love for all. And so we recall on the night in which he gave himself up for us. He took bread. He blessed it. gave thanks and he broke it. And he just simply said, take and eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When the supper was over, he took a cup as they reclined at the table. He lifted it and he blessed it. And he gave thanks and he gave it to his disciples, his friends, people like you and me, and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins, your mistakes. And so do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Pray with me. Holy God, descend your spirit upon these gifts of bread and fruit of the vine, that they might be for us the presence of the living Christ. Pour out your spirit upon us at your house of prayer and upon those who are connected with us. And in doing so, may we live in communion with you and one another. In Christ we pray. Amen and amen. The bread and the cup have been blessed. No matter what or where they are, we now invite you, to share this sacred meal.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. Be not
so I can consume this meal for all those who are present, all those who have gone before, all those that we miss. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Onetta. Beautiful communion time. We want to thank you for being with us today. Thank you for being in worship with us. Thank you for all that you mean to us. Thank you for those who have transferred their membership. We're so excited about that. Thank you for those who have reached out with their memories of Keith Minion this week. We appreciate that as well. We're also excited to have a brand new member, Derek. He's still on my phone, by the way. I had to put it down there on the floor so he can watch what's going on.
We love you, Derek.
I don't know if you can hear them, Derek. They're saying they love you. We're really glad to see you. Thank you for getting up so early and being a blessing to this church. In just a few moments, we're going to sing a song, and then Bob will be back to take our offering. And then before we go off air, let me give you a little bit of instruction. So just hang with us in just a minute, because we're having a congregational meeting shortly, in about 30 minutes, in fact. So hang in there with us. Sing with us now.
It's what I live for. Nothing will keep me from all that you have for me. You hold my head up high. I live for you. Greater is he that's living in me than he that is in the world. Faith, I can move the mountains. I can do all things through Christ. I know. Who strengthens me, faith. I'm reaching for the prize, I'm giving everything. I give my life for this, that's what I live for. Nothing can keep me from all that you have for me. You hold my head up high, I live for you. Greater is he that's living in me than he that is in the world. Faith, I can move the mountains. I can do all things through Christ. I know faith, standing and believing, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Faith.
All right. Come on, sing with us wherever you are. Greater is he.
Greater is he that's living in me than he that is in the world. Oh, faith, I can move the mountains. I can do all things through Christ. I know, faith, standing and believing, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Faith, I can move the mountains. I can do all things through Christ. I know faith, standing and believing, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Faith.
Amen.
You guys are a hard act to follow. But now is the time to for the calling of the tithe that helps us maintain this church in so many different ways and helps us reach out to so many people in so many different ways. The easiest way to make a tithe is on the website up at the link. Again, if it's for just for the general fund, great. If you want to make a special offer, break somehow, just put it in the notation. And we will take care of it. But also, if you wish to do the old-fashioned way and mail it in, that's okay too. So thank you much, and I look forward to seeing everybody at the congregational meeting.
As Bob said, you can see those notes from those slides. You can give by going to the little red banner on the front page of our website, and just make sure you note whether it's for your regular offering or building fund or some other fund that you want to give to. Just a little instruction before I pray the benediction. Momentarily, after I pray the benediction, service will be concluded, or the worship time will be concluded here in the sanctuary. And there, you can go online to hospitality. Some people love to come into our hospitality time afterwards. That link is on the front page of our website. So you're welcome to go see that, and just click on the link and it will take you directly there. At 11:45, we will begin our congregational meeting. This is our fall congregational meeting, and we invite you, if you have a Zoom account, you can go directly from the link on our website.
If you will go to where it says Board of Directors, down on the front page, it has the information about the congregational meeting. So you can just find that on the front page of our website. Go to that and click on that, and it has that. You can, if you do not have Zoom and you don't want a Zoom account, well, don't panic. There's actually a phone number there, and you can phone in. So between 11:35 and 11:45, you can call in or Zoom in. We prefer you Zoom in because we can see you, and it may save us a little bit of time at the beginning. Please be patient. Since we're doing it virtually for the first time, we want to be patient with one another. We've run through this. We've practiced it. We spent over 2 hours yesterday practicing this congregational meeting, and I'm so excited for the people that are making things happen. But at the beginning, we're going to need to count the people, and we have to check names. You do not have to be a member of the church to come to the meeting, but you do have to be a member in order to vote. So Derek, if you're up and you want to join us at the congregational meeting, you just became a member, but you are a member. You can vote in these elections. So we want you to join us if you'd like to. That is a separate call than the hospitality. So if you can't just leave hospitality and then the meeting starts, you have to go off of the hospitality link and go to a different link for the congregational meeting. We are also going to do our best to keep the meeting to around an hour to an hour and 15 minutes because we want to honor our members of the Latino service that starts at 1:30. We want to make sure that we have concluded the meeting so that they can be in the meeting just as much as the rest of us who have already had service. So just a few little reminders, and we'll start the meeting promptly at 11:45. But you can come into the waiting room ahead of that. And if you come into the waiting room between 11:35 and 11:45, that will help our clerk to be able to check your name off as being present. Would you pray with me now? God, thank you. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for blessing us and letting your comforter be with us this week in our losses. Thank you for these who have transferred their membership and the one who has joined. Thank you, God, that we have people that have volunteered their ministries, their services for the offices that we have to elect today. We thank you for their willingness to give of their time and their talents, and yes, even their finances, to make those ministries happen, make those ministries work. We now ask that you will be with us through this roller coaster of emotions, this roller coaster of life. Help us at the end of each day to remember, though, that God, you are with us, and that the peace of God that passes all understanding is guarding our hearts and our minds. We ask all of this in the name of Jesus our Christ and all that is holy. Amen. God bless you. I'll see you in just a few minutes at the congregational meeting.